few months ago I was contacted by the elk guys who asked me whether I wanted to help them by evaluating the development board that they were creating for the Raspberry Pi. Now, last time we worked together, I already came up with an algorithm for a sustenuto effect, which I had the pleasure to present at an international scientific conference. And I thought that this algorithm would be the perfect target to implement a real device around in order to indeed evaluate this board thoroughly. So I started with a regular VST3 implementation of the algorithm, and all I had to do to have it working on the board was actually recompiling it with the supply toolchain, flashing an SD card, creating an Ethernet connection between the board and my desktop computer, transferring the files over SSH, and creating a configuration file for Sushi, which is the plugin host on the board, and finally launching plugin. Then I added two physical knobs controlling dry and wet levels, and also a momentary switch which activates the sostenuto effect, and a couple of status LEDs. These are controlled by Sensei, which is the daemon that deals with sensors and transducers, and for which I also had to write a small configuration file. Sensei outputs OSC messages, which are translated into gRPC calls by another small Python script that I had to write, and which is known in the elk world as the Glue application. Finally, I configured Linux to run Sushi, Sensei and the Glue application at boot, and set the mounting of partitions as read-only in order to avoid SD card corruption when, for example, pulling off the plug suddenly. This might seem much, but I've done all of this in a few evenings and I really enjoyed the process and I really liked the results. But in order to make the whole thing like a real product, now I also needed to make a pedal enclosure around it.
Stefano D'Angelo è un prototipo di Sound Retainer di ottima qualità. Tutto quello che ci permette di fare è praticamente congelare il segnale per mezzo secondo e creare delle sovrapposizioni timbriche al di sopra di esso, quindi lascia spazio alla creatività del musicista. È possibile utilizzarlo anche soltanto come sustainer, quindi possiamo decidere quanto tempo può essere congelato il segnale. Credo sia un prodotto molto semplice e intuitivo da utilizzare e che, nonostante sia ancora un prototipo, è un prodotto molto valido ed interessante.